Luke chapter 1. Get my place here. Luke chapter 1, verse 30. We're going through the Gospel of Luke. We've been from chapter 1, verse 1, all the way to verse 30. There's audio or video that you can find the links to download and listen to and pass out and get out the word. The angel said unto her, Mary, fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. Okay. Now we're dealing with Mary. We dealt with... Hold on, let me get back to where we were. I'm looking at my notes here. Okay. Alright. Favor is mentioned twice. In verse 29, it says, when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. It's in her thoughts. The angel knew her thoughts. He knew that she had fear. And he comforts her. This is something that Jesus is going to do through his ministry. The disciples are out in a boat in the middle of a storm. Fear not. Those are famous words of Jesus. Now this favor that we're going to see. Thou hast found favor with God. Now that's a great thing. God is giving her favor. Let's go to Genesis 4:4. Genesis 4:4. All the way back. We're going to look at some favor. And what is it? Genesis 4:4, and Abel, he also brought of the firstlings of his flock and of the fat thereof. And the Lord had respect unto Abel and to his offering. It's a respect. It's an honor. God said, I approve of that offer. Mary, I approve of what you're doing, of who you are. Chapter 6, verse 8 of Genesis. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Grace. The grace that God showed Abel by receiving that offer, the fire came down. The grace that's going to happen to Mary, she's going to be carrying and being the mother of Jesus, the only begotten Son of God. I didn't say the mother of God. Noah is a man that is honored, respected for what he believed in God. Abel did what God wanted him to do. Noah did what God wanted him to do. Mary done what God wanted her to do. Chapter 39:21. See, God's favor just is not put upon anybody and everybody. Don't you walk, oh, God show me favor, and you're living wrong and unrighteously. That doesn't happen. Genesis 39:21. But the Lord was with Joseph and showed him mercy and gave him favor, mercy and favor, in the sight of the keeper of the prison. Now God's mercy and favor can show up even the hard times and places of your life. Joseph is cast into jail wrongfully. He would have the right to say, I appeal to this woman because of what she lied about, and would be found innocent. But He takes with what God has put in his life. And he's favored. He obeys God. Again, you see that with Noah, and you see that with Abel, and you see it with Mary. Now, Exodus 2:25. Wow, we jump a lot of pages and chapters. Froggy in my voice that time. And God looked upon the children of Israel, and God had respect unto them. This is the whole entire nation of Israel in Egypt under bondage. And God says, you know what? He says, I love you. And he takes them as a bride. Even though God has foreknowledge, he knows what these Jews are going to do to him. He says, I respect you. But this is based upon their family relationship of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and the 12 tribes. That God made covenants with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob because of their obedience. That their children, do you hear what I said? That if you obey God and do what you're supposed to do and live right, your children may get the respect from God. Because if you read on to Revelation, those Jewish people were anything but living for God and doing right as a nation. First Samuel 2:26. The child Samuel grew on and was in favor both with the Lord, capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D, and also with men. Now Luke 2:40, that's a type of Jesus Christ. Samuel is a young boy. His heart wants to know God, and his life shows it. He's under a priest that is false, it's wrong, sinning. He has a dedicated mother that when she's got troubles in life, she goes to the Lord and puts a vow to the Lord and gives the Lord her all. And this child, before he even starts, God respects him. On what he done? No. On what his heart and his motive is. See, Noah hadn't built the ark yet. But God knew his heart. Your heart has to be right with God for you to have favor. And you've got to do what God has already got laid out in your life before you start. Samuel is going to anoint the two kings of Israel, and one of them is David. Samuel's going to know David. We don't even know who David is. I mean, I'm talking about we haven't met David. We haven't seen him. Samuel did. Proverbs 3:1. Proverbs 3:1. Proverbs 3:1. My son, forget not my law, but let thy heart keep my commandments. For length of days and long life and peace shall they add to thee. Let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them about thy neck. Write them upon the table of thy heart. Alright? You get verses 1, 2, and 3 down. Verse 4 is the result. So shalt thou find favor and good understanding in the sight of God and man. And who did we have for the example for that? Who can we go back in the Bible and read? Samuel. We just read that. So you go back and study Samuel, and you will get chapter 3, verses 1 through 3. Study Jesus. But we can't when that's quoted in Luke, because we don't. Only thing we know about is when he was 12 years old. And like Samuel, Jesus would not really have the word because the priests were all corrupt. So Samuel's a type of Jesus Christ. You realize Samuel is in the temple. He's in the priestly quarters of Eli. He's sleeping, and the Lord calls him 3 times, and even the priest didn't get the point for the 3rd time. Go to sleep, boys. It's bothering me. No, I didn't call you. Go to bed. Well, maybe God's speaking. Next time, say yes, Lord, speak. You know? So you are to study Bible characters. To learn. Chapter 8, verse 32 of Proverbs. 8:32. This is a weird one. I got 8:32 to 25. I don't think so. I'll try to read 30. 35. Now therefore hearken unto me, O ye children. Hearken unto who? Who's writing? Solomon. Hearken to Proverbs. Hearken to Ecclesiastes. Hearken to the Song of Solomon. A man who got God's wisdom. Who the Bible says he was far more wise than all those of the Orient. He got it from God. O ye children, for blessed, didn't we just see that? Are they that keep my ways. Hear instruction and be wise, and refuse it not. Blessed is the man that heareth me, watcheth daily at my gates, waiteth at the post of my doors. He's talking about wisdom again. You need God's wisdom. All right? Get verse 32 to 34. Get that down. Again, like chapter 3. Then you can get verse 35. For whosoever finds me findeth life and obtains favor of the Lord. See, favor doesn't come to young little Mary. Does it? Mary had wisdom. And the angel Gabriel says it is so by reading Proverbs 3, 1 through 3, and reading Proverbs 8, 32 to 34. By what type of girl she was, Then we get 3:4. Then we get 8:35. And then we get the angels telling us exactly who Mary was and her conduct, which goes along the line of Abel, Noah, Samuel, and wisdom. Mary was not just, you know, God didn't roll dice, all right, if it's number 5, it's going to be Mary, okay? Number 5, God, that's not how God... And you know what? The Roman Catholics raised Mary on a pedestal as God, and they are wrong. And do you know what? The Baptists do not raise Mary as who she really is, which is wrong. Oh, she's just Mary, she's just the mother of Jesus. There's a lot of mothers out there that should not be mothers. Do you realize what we have just read so far in just Proverbs 3 and 8 alone? Mary raised Jesus, even though Jesus is God and knew the word, she raised that boy to be in wisdom. She raised her boy to be right with God, even though he is God. Now let me ask you a question. You think she just did that with Jesus, or do you think she did it with all her children? Okay? Now say to yourself, we're not done with favor. We don't know, but I assume she did. If she raised it with all her children, I'm a godly mother, I've raised my children in the Bible, and some of not all my children didn't come out right. Not all Mary's children came out right. God will reward that mother for doing right, and God will reward that child for doing wrong. And listen, mother, if you did right and your child turned out wrong, listen to me. God's going to reward you properly for what you've done and all you could do. That child is going to be judged in loss of favor because you know what? He went against the mother. He went against the mother's prayers. He went against the mother's teaching. And he went against God by giving him a godly mother. Boy, is he going to suffer. Chapter 12, verse 2 of Proverbs on this favor. Chapter 12, verse 2. Let's see Mary again. I know it says man, but let's see Mary. A good man obtains favor of the Lord. Noah, Joseph were good men. And yet the Bible says, for there is none good. Now, is that a contradiction? Or are you walking in the Lord and God says, you know what? I see you good in the eyes of my son. You've seen all the attributes so far you have to be favor of God. We're not done. The good man attains favor of the Lord, but a man of wicked devices will he condemn. Mary didn't think wicked. She didn't plan to get devised. She was a humble and meek young lady, according to Gabriel. Gabriel said it. I didn't. God told Gabriel, go down there and tell that young lady, I'm giving her favor. And what is the favor? A favor that no woman in the world can say. I gave birth and mothered Jesus Christ. Let me take that back. I said, no woman. No woman in the world can say, I gave birth to the only begotten Son of God, the Lord Jesus Christ, and mothered him. And there's people out there who have been born Jesus. A You know? Chapter 18:22 of Proverbs. Proverbs 18:22. Look at this one. Whosoever finds a wife findeth a good thing. Now you know what? What did Gabriel tell Mary that thing was? Not, I just told you. When he says that you're going to be impregnated with that thing, he said, "Find a good thing." Well, don't be downcast, woman, wife. Oh, I've been called a thing. Jesus Christ in the womb was called a thing. You find that in Luke chapter 2. We'll be studying that. Wait, we study soon. Not pretty soon, but soon. I have no fear of going slow. I wouldn't get it off. And there's an and. Conjunction, conjunction. What's your function? I found a good thing. I found a wife. And obtain favor of the Lord. Well, everybody that has a wife has obtained favor of the Lord. There's some wives that Solomon talks about that are not favor of the Lord. But that's what the verse says. Wives are not battle axes. They're not the old lady. They're not scum. Yes, I believe a woman should be a homemaker, a bearer of children, the provider of her husband and children. But she's not a slave. You know, I don't have to force my wife. Most of the time, my wife will come to me and say, would you like, or can I make you, do you know? Do it, woman, or else. No. Wait till God said, do it or else, you know. Luke 2:52, and my eyeballs are starting to go. Gotta apologize. My fault reading is it's lower allergies bothers my eyeballs. Alright, now watch this. Here's the verse. And this is God. You believe Jesus is God, right? I do. Jesus increased in wisdom. Where'd you read that? Proverbs 3. Proverbs 8. And stature. And in favor with God and man. And you run that back to Samuel. 1 Samuel 2:26. You run that with Proverbs 3:1-4. And 8:32-35. There's an inner circle of favor. Are you like a Samuel? Do you even know who Samuel is? Have you obeyed Solomon? Before you, well, God has showed me favor. You know, God has maybe sent that wife to you, 8:22, as a prayer warrior because of your pathetic life, mister. I'm trying to think what the king's name is there. He's a wicked king. He dies. And the Bible records his mother is saying, where is my son? Where is he? You know, shouldn't he have been home from war by now? Yeah, I can't think of his name.
He
you know, you got favoritism, and God has requirements. And a woman that we see with Mary, this is as far as we're going to get. Mary, Luke chapter 1, Mary chapter 1. I'm surprised Catholics don't have a Mary book. Mary chapter 1. If they do, it's because I said it. Oh, no. Mary, I was going to say it again, Mary chapter 1. Once you get stuck in something. It says in verse 30, and the angel said unto her, fear not, Mary. That's what Jesus would say. For thou hast found favor with God. Do you know how many Christian wives of Christian men who have served the Lord and a wife has been home while the husband's away? And the Bible says, and David, who is a type of Christ, that she that tarries by the stuff is going to earn the same rewards that her husband gets. Right? Now, wouldn't this tell us what kind of character Joseph is too? We're going to see later on when I think we talked about Joseph last week. You can get that video or the audio. Joseph obeyed God. Listen, he wants to put Mary away, and the angel comes to him and says, no, don't do that. And he explains to him, okay. And night one time, it says the angel came to speak to him. He's like, oh, man, too much pepperoni pizza. Ooh. No. The Lord tells him at one point, he says, okay, go home. And I can guarantee, he kindly tells the Lord, he says, Lord, but, okay, I'll do that, but this other man sit in the throne, and I fear him. And the angel says, yeah. All right, go here. That way, when you go there, the scriptures can be fulfilled. See, Joseph's words fulfilled the scripture. Now, tonight's lesson about Mary, and I assume with Joseph, she's no common, ordinary girl. And there may have been hundreds, I don't know, thousands, I don't know, I wouldn't say millions, of other girls just like her who loved the Lord and wanted to do right. But with Genesis 4:4, Genesis 6:8, 39:21, 1 Samuel 2:26, Proverbs 3:1-3, then the result, verse 4, Proverbs 8:32-34, then the result, 35. We don't teach Mary as high as we should. God did not leave the care of his son from infancy all the way to 30 years old in the hands of just any old woman. And even Mary makes mistakes, and they left Jesus behind when he was 12 years old. See, the Catholics, again, put her too much as a god, and the Baptists give her too little credit. But when you run scripture with scripture, this is an extraordinary girl. And my question would be today in America, if you were to take all the Baptist churches, and you were to gather the girls to be like Mary in one building, what size building would you need? And yet, when we read in Proverbs 18:22, a woman who becomes a wife is the favor of God to that man, and if you raise that girl wrong, She becomes that strange woman. She becomes that contentious woman that Solomon warns about. So where do we also get with Mary? What do you get with Timothy? His mother and his grandmother loved the Lord and taught him right. Somebody in Mary's family, mother, I don't know, we don't know if it's the mother or the father or both, or like Timothy was his mother and his grandmother, somebody raised Mary right. You know how I know that? Because Mary was favored of God. Somebody got to call Jesus their grandchild. How do you like that? Here, Mary, let me hold my grandchild, God. Sure. You ever think about that? Where do you get that from? Tell me a book in the Bible where I am speaking of right now that you find that happens. How about Ruth? Where Naomi, the grandmother, takes that child, Boaz, Obed, and holds the father of David. And you run that line, and Ruth is found in the line of the Lord Jesus Christ. You run that line, and Luke chapter 3 will be coming to eventually, maybe, if the Lord tarries. You find Mary in the line of the Lord Jesus Christ. And it's so wonderful because God is wonderful. And through Mary, if you look at chapter 3, verse 38, which was the son of Enos, which was the son of Seth, which is the son of Adam, which is the son of God. Through Mary's line, you go all the way back to the beginning. To the one who didn't have a belly button, who is the son of God. God says, listen, I'll show you about marriage. I'll name her all the way back to Adam. I think like Tim, I could be wrong. You don't have to take this, but I think like Timothy had a godly mother and grandmother. Somebody was a grandparent to Jesus Christ. Now, that says a lot from the first book that we talked about, the first part, Zacharias. See, Zacharias had a Jewish history that matched his life. And we haven't even got to the tip of the iceberg with Mary yet. Here this man walks into, we don't even know if it's a room, but this man walks somewhere up to Mary and says, I'm sent from God, you're highly favored, and she's humble. And it's never happened for Mary. And we went through a great detail talking about Zacharias and how he should have known there was something special. And he didn't. Meanwhile, while the angel is talking to Mary, it is 6 months, and Zacharias cannot say a word. Let's give Mary a little more credit. She has a lot of attributes that the Bible that we read the references today for her to be favored. She had to have at least, I assume you ask me, it would be a woman, Timothy. She had to have at least a godly mother and a godly grandmother that raised her right. Zacharias should have known that was no ordinary man in the temple, in the holy place. This man walks up to Mary and she doesn't question nothing. She fears. That's normal. I mean, here's this strange guy. I mean, I'd fear too. And she starts believing every word he says. That's about Mary. And wait till what she tells us about Jesus Christ later when the Lord tarries. Wait till we get to Mary's commandment.